table. You could actually see that table in several things that we saw depicted in that mosaic in the Holy Trinity show. It had a little table there, a little pile of books on it. And then one of the other, right there underneath the Martin Luther, the last statue we saw, there was also a table there which depicted that pretty well. But they put in everything that Martin Luther had written on there. Little treatise, pamphlets, brochures, books. And Eck got up and just tore into Martin Luther, and he said to him, are these yours? Meaning, are you the author? Is this your penmanship? Just like we saw Joshua's penmanship, his authorship of his book about Elijah. And so they said, is this your penmanship? Are you the authors? And of course he agreed that it was. And then, will you recant? Eck said to him, and he said, well, I'd like to answer that question tomorrow. Maybe he was thinking about John Huss, and maybe he was just delaying for his own benefit. But anyway, he did, and Charles V gave him permission, and he did come back the following day, which was April the 18th, and gave that famous statement talking about the scriptures, sola scriptura, and how he believed that the authority didn't rest, in creeds, councils, or the clerics, but, rested in the authority of the word. And he stood on that, and those famous words, here I stand, we saw that engraved in a number of places. Some think he said it that day, some think it was added later in the writing, but it's become, somewhat immortalized and etched on the blackboards of our minds, here I stand. And some of us stood in his shoes there. That's pretty cool. I enjoyed that. That's a good symbolic picture of what it means to here I stand. And so after saying that, of course, Charles V declared him guilty, declared him a heretic, and punishment by death. But Charles V gave him 21 days to get his things in order before his execution. And so he left Worms on the way back to Wittenberg, and Joseph mentioned that, where these masked, armed horsemen come out of the woods, and they apprehend him, they capture him, they kidnap him. And Martin Luther didn't know it at the moment, but Frederick the Wise had arranged that. And they whisk him off to the Wittenberg castle, where he stayed for 11 months, and living in a hiding condition. Anonymously, he changed his appearance, grew his hair long, grew a beard, took a new name, Junker George, George the Knight, and spent 11 months there. And as it turned out, they were probably the most 11 profitable months of his own whole ministry, in a sense, because it was there in those 11 months that he translated the Greek New Testament into German. And then eventually, when the Holy Roman lifted the ban on him, he was able to leave the Wittenberg Castle and go back to Wittenberg. And, sometime after that, they published the New Testament, in German, the language of the people. And it became, obviously, an instant bestseller. The common people bought it. The ecclesiastical clergy bought it. The political elites bought it. It sold faster than the Apple iPhone 8. It just sold like hotcakes, and everybody wanted to be able to read the New Testament in their native tongue. And it really sparked the Reformation, in the sense that it was like a fire that just flew across a prairie wildfire for those of us from the U.S. So that really kicked it off and started. He became, obviously a strong man of the word. And someone later asked him, Martin, how did you do all this? And he said, well, I really didn't do anything. The Word did everything. That's a good reminder for us, particularly as preachers. The Word does everything. We just got to preach the Word, teach the Word, stand true to the Word, and be faithful about doing that. And so I just thought that it helped me to capsulize that a little bit, thinking about and everything that Joseph said, looking at all the monuments. And so why don't we just bow our heads and hearts and pray together just for a moment. Father, we thank you for your Word. You tell us that your word is truth. It's been forever settled in the heavens. And we're grateful that, Lord, we can learn so much more this week. Thank you for Joseph, Lord. Thank you for the tremendous, immense knowledge that he has about so many of these topics, and how helpful it has been for us, even though we've only been with him one afternoon. Pray for our bus driver, too, Lord. Just pray for that hedge of thorns of protection around him. keep him alert, help us to be safe as we drive back to Mans. And Lord, we're grateful for this opportunity to be here on the Reformation Tour, and trust, Lord Jesus, that we can bring honor and glory to you as you conform us to your image, as we can be the strong men and women of God that you want us to be, and we'll be sure to give you all the glory. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.